We are really excited about our next guest. Brothers Osborne, the Grammy-nominated country duo, are back on tour performing songs from their third album, Skeletons. Here's a taste of their new music video for the song, I'm Not For Everyone, featuring, you'll see, actor Leslie Jordan in a gold and glitter suit.
I'm like scotch inside a gold band. I'm like Eastside Towns, Van Zandt. I'm always speaking my mind.
And TJ and John Osborne are right here in Studio 57. Yay. Welcome to you both. It's so great to see you. It's
great to be here.
And you literally pulled up in your tour bus this morning.
Which is still outside.
Which was.
Yeah.
You came down from Syracuse and you just dropped in.
Yeah, we did. We have now determined that's the best way to get into the city. It's not via LaGuardia. It's just pull in a tour bus, jump off into there.
You've been back on the road for how long?
I don't know.
A couple months south. We got started kind of in June. In July, it really ramped up. And it's been, God, I don't even know what month it is right now.
it's August.
So how's it feeling to be back on the road? Because this album came out, you recorded it, what, like a year and a half ago?
Yeah, we recorded it. So we started in 2019. The irony behind this record, we don't really go into it thinking about it too much. But this record, we're like, let's make something that we can perform live. Like, get out and perform live to people. And then had we known a pandemic was going to happen, we might have changed our strategy.
Yes.
But we're back. Everything's a little weird. It's all up. We're taking a lot of precautions. But it does feel amazing to be back.
Yeah.
TJ. And I'm thinking people are glad to see you, too. What's it like for the fans and when you make connection with the fans? Because they've missed you just as much as you've missed them.
Absolutely. And it's interesting to mention that because there are a lot of fans that we do recognize that have seen us play a ton of times, and it's been amazing to see them. But the crowds have been really, really fun. You can tell people are having a really good time. And we were we weren't really sure how it was all going to play out as we went back out on tour. I mean, there were so many variables that were happening, so many reasons not to do it. But ultimately, we went back out to do it, mainly to see the fans.
It was interesting because they just had the big concert in Central Park over the weekend, and a lot of the performers said this was the first time they'd been in front of an audience. Yeah. And they also said something that surprised me, that they were nervous going back out.
I was nervous the first time.
Why, John?
I don't know. I have this weird thing about performing, and I'd mentioned this when we chatted several months ago. I don't get nervous performing, but it was like, I don't know. It's like seeing someone you haven't seen in a long time that you really love.
Do they still love me?
Yeah, do they still love me? But to be honest with you, and everyone felt it, but as soon as we played the first note, it's like we'd never left.
Yes. Yeah. Talk about this song, I'm Not For Everyone. You say it really resonated with fans. Why do you think so?
Yeah, well, I mean, I think honestly, John and I, you know, we talk about this a lot. I think that the song really came from us just realizing. People ask us, when did it feel like you made it? And honestly, it was when we got haters.
And, I love this part. Yes.
You're
big enough for people to hate your guts.
Exactly. We made it. People hate us. But you know, and it did bother us at first for a long time. And then you get to this point where you just say, like, you know what? I like who I am. I'm okay with that. If you don't, it's kind of narcissistic to expect everyone.
Can you tell us how Leslie Jordan ended up in the video?
Leslie, you got lost.
Wrong term.
Documentary footage.
I did this project with Leslie, and he did all these gospel songs, and I did a song with Leslie and got to know him there. And then, so we asked him to be a part of it. They wanted a character that, they were like, we want to have this character that looks like he really doesn't belong. And I was like, Leslie.
So, he's terrific, though, isn't he?
Tribute to Leslie.
So amazing. You know, we don't like being in our videos. I mean, that's the most I think we've ever been in one of our videos. And because, I don't know, it's hard to even act as yourself. It's really hard acting. And he showed up like, so what am I doing today? I'm like, you're not even prepared. No. He just walked in there and owned it. I mean, he's truly amazing.
You know, TJ, it's interesting what you say about haters, because I think you can get 1,000 compliments, but you get that one from some cranky Yankee, and that's the one that sticks with us.
Right.
Please explain that to me.
Yeah, I don't really understand how to navigate. I don't get that either. Because another thing that happens too is you can have like 30 or 40 amazing shows, and you have one that just bombs, and it makes you just. I'm like, I can't do this anymore. I don't think I'm cut out for this. Like, it just all comes crashing down. And I think, you know, this industry is definitely takes a lot of perseverance and just kind of getting back up again and again and again. Because, I mean, we get told no way more than we're ever told yes.
Really?
And so, I mean, just to get to where you are. Yeah. But, which is, that is the hard part of what we do. However, the beautiful part of it is that we do get to go out and have fun. I mean, it's really amazing that we get to do this for a living and get to
and
play.
And your brothers. Can you talk about the brother dynamic? Because Anthony just had that great story about the one brother that struck the other one out.
I know.
I hadn't heard about that. We were watching you from side stage, and I was like, oh, my God, that sounds terrifying. For the dad who has to deal with that afterwards, you
but
know?
But you two aren't really competing, really,
no,
are you?
Fortunately, I grew up, all I wanted to do was play guitar, and then TJ just naturally wanted to sing. So, you know, he's a great guitar player, and I can sing okay. But we fill in the gaps. And I know we've been talking a lot about Don Everly passing. I mean, we never really wanted to go in that way of trying to be like the Everly Brothers. First off, I'm not good enough of a singer to even do that.
You're not going to beat them.
And second, you can't beat them. So yeah. Fortunately for us, it just kind of worked out to where there's no rivalry. Now, it doesn't mean that we don't have our moments.
Yeah.
But it's never that we're competing for the same space.
But you actually both, you went to Nashville separately. You didn't go together. You
right.
were singing.
Right,
you were yeah. playing guitar for other folks.
Yes.
And people kept saying, when you did play together, why aren't you together, right?
Exactly. Yeah, yeah. Which was really, at first, you know, our mother always wanted us to play together. So naturally, we're like, we're not doing that.
Yeah. Yeah.
And Mom, you were right.
She'll tell you, yeah. too.
Yeah, she will.
Do you ever gently have advice for one another? His singing, his guitar playing, maybe, you know, take it back here, try this.
Who, our mom or each other?
Each other.
Oh, no, we avoid that at all.
Oh,
really?
Yeah,
good. Yeah.
That is atomic.
You so can, you can say, how did that sound? Great. Love
yeah,
it.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
In all honesty, you know, I know we do get to do this as brothers, and we have this, but John truly is an incredible guitar player, and he's a
Thank
guitar
you.
Player's guitar player. Now, I would not dare tell him how to play something on guitar.
You never say it's not good, and just say, let's try once more from the top.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah. No, and the same. I mean, he's obviously a very great singer, so we're very lucky in that respect. There's never a moment where the weird irony about that, though, is I am singing on our current single, but it wasn't to release as a single. We thought, hey, it'd be cool just to do it for a song.
Yeah.
I think the fans will like it. It's just something a little different. And then it ends up on the radio. And had I known it was going to be on the radio, I probably would have tried to sing it a little better. But whatever. I mean, it's permanent now.
So what did you think when you heard it on the radio?
I thought, I was like, all right, that's not so bad, I guess. You know, it could be worse.
This is younger then.
What's that?
This is...
Which... No, not younger. I mean, this is the current yeah. single, I'm Not For Everyone.
I'm Not For... Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay,
I'm
yeah.
singing the second verse on that, which is cool. I mean, it's
yeah.
the first song that John takes a lead vocal part on. So it's a cool moment for us now, however many singles in.
Yeah.
You know, I love, TJ, that you came out. It was very well received. But I love this tweet that one of your fans, because we get good tweets, too.
I like that. Let's talk.
Yeah, this is good. This fan said, I'm so thankful that she's talking about her teenage son, that he gets to live in a world where he doesn't have to hide who he is.
Love that.
And his men, I love it, too. And then he has men like the two of you that he can look up to.
Yeah.
What does that mean to you? And how has your life changed, if at all, after you made that decision?
You know, my life has changed in a lot of ways, and I've been talking about this in the shows. I think I didn't realize kind of what a sense of purpose it would bring to my life to be here. I didn't realize how much it would resonate with some people. And to think about that especially, I wasn't really thinking about the parents of children who are queer or whatever they are and how that would really help them to be able to help their relationship. That was something that never dawned on me. We were at Asbury Park just not long ago, and this girl was shouting out. She was like, come over here, which could be a whole bag of tricks. I'm like, what is she
You never know,
yeah.
yes.
Yeah, and I come over, and she's like, come here, and she wants me to get really close, and I'm like, okay. And then she's like, hey, you know, and she's like, I just want to thank you for making a safe space for people like me to come to the show. And I thought, like, wow, like, that is, to me, that is worth more than anything that I've ever anything, certainly anything monetary.
I think that's beautiful.
Nothing feels better than
beautiful.
That.
It does. Yeah, exactly. You're
it
right.
It is gorgeous.
Yeah.
And it's wonderful to have you guys here. I think you might be blocking traffic on 57th, but we've got to wrap them up.
Well, we just met lovely Lucy, your better half.
Yes. Yeah. She's in there. She should be here speaking. She's much more beautiful and articulate and smart than me.
She's
but,
a doll.
You know.
Well, you said you have anxiety, but you do this stuff so well.
Oh, I'm an expert at hiding it. I can do things. I can play guitar and hide my anxiety.
TJ, John, love having you guys here.
Love you. Love you all.
All right. Thank you so much for being here.